Hi friends, good afternoon to all of you. Welcome to our channel Honest Advisors. So today we will be discussing about various aspects of retail loans. Friends, this topic is helpful in promotion examinations for banks, other recruitment examinations and JIIB and CAIIB examinations. So let us start our lecture for today. We will be discussing about characteristics of retail banking, advantages of retail banking, types of retail loans, eligibility criteria and quantum of loans, and challenges faced in retail loans. What is retail banking? Retail banking is offering of banking products and services to individual customers, typically non-entrepreneurship purpose. The most visible face of banking for the general public is retail banking. Retail banking begins with the mass banking and graduates to class retail banking. Now, definition of retail loans as per Basel III capital regulations dated July 1st, 2015 is Basel identifies four criteria for retail credit. First is product criteria, as per which the retail loan products are simple and structured products. Number two, orientation criteria, exposure to a person or to small business where annual turnover of the unit not exceed 50 crores. Amount criteria, less than 5 crores to individual. Granularity criteria, the loan should be well diversified. No counterparty to be lent more than 0.2% of total retail portfolio. Loans include both fund-based and non-fund-based that meet all the four criteria listed may be considered as retail claims for regulatory capital purpose and included in a regulatory retail portfolio. Claims included in this portfolio shall be assigned a risk weight of 75%. Characteristics of retail banking. So, the three basic characteristics of retail banking are multiple products like deposits, credit cards, insurance, investment, securities. Number two, multiple channels of distributions like branch, internet, mobile, call centers. Multiple customer groups like consumer, small business, corporate groups. Kinds of retail loans. So, retail loans can be taken by individuals for personal needs like credit cards, personal loans, vehicle loans, consumer durable loans, home loans, gold jewelry loans, loan against shares, financial securities, education loans. Second is loan taken by individuals for business professional needs like car loans for taxi purpose, three-wheeler loans for passenger cargo transport, truck loans, construction equipment loans, medical equipment, office equipment loans. Loans taken by sole proprietorship firms, partnership firms, LLPs, companies for business purpose like vehicle dealership and service centers, loan against property, lease rental discounting comes under the purview of retail loans. Let us see the profile of retail customers. Now, the profile of retail customer involves stability of jobs like government jobs, banks, blue chip companies, quasi-government organizations, public sector units. Other classes, working in second tier private companies but highly qualified set of people, doing good business, SME large industry sector or in service sector. Professionals, doctors, lawyers, CA, engineer, similar qualified professionals. Semi-skilled professionals like beauticians, data entry operator, electrician, plumber, etc. or self-employed. And the last class is unskilled people. Let us see the reasons for growth in retail loans. The first reason is population growth. Second reason is demography change, that is moving towards younger population. Third reason is growing consumerism, growing disposable income, increasing literacy levels, higher adaptability to technology, desire to improve lifestyle, easy availability of credit like credit cards and bank credit. The other reasons for growth are robust demand. Robust demand is due to increasing working population and growing disposable income will raise the demand of banking and related services. Rural banking is also expected to increase in the future. Innovation in services, mobile banking, internet banking and various extensions of facilities at the ATM stations will improve the operational efficiency. Business fundamentals, Healthy business fundamentals can be reflected through high interest margins. Policy support. The industry has healthy regulatory oversight along with credible monetary policy by the Reserve Bank of India. Factors affecting retail loans. So, retail lending depends upon product, price, process, delivery, and innovation. Product development in retail banking. Research, market dynamics, customer segments, market conditions. Cross-selling and product bundling opportunities are structured and implemented around retail asset products. Process time is a major differentiator in the efficacy of retail banking operations. Pricing of products and services depends upon market dynamics, risk perception, return expectations, tenor, asset liability management position, and customer profile. Now, let us see the sanction process flow of retail loans. So, step 1 is obtaining of documents from the customer. This involves obtaining of application forms, KYC documents, income documents like latest salary slip, Form 16, last 3 years ITR, employment professional details of proponent, asset and liability statements, bank statements, address proof, identity proof, and age proof. Property details like quotations, estimates, etc. Step 2. Personal discussion, source of margin, repayment ability, etc. Step 3. Bank's field inspection, which involves technical feasibility. Step 4. Economic viability and bankability. In technical feasibility, living standard, locality, telephonic verification, educational qualification, political influence, references. In living standards, decent living standard with some tangible like car, TV and fridge will provide assurance to bank regarding your residential status. Locality, presence of some undesirable elements like local goons or controversial areas adversely affects your loan appraisal process. Telephonic verification, at least one response is needed from person to establish the identity of the person from contact point of view. Educational qualification, not an essential barrier but essential to understand the complex terms and conditions of a bank loan. Political influence, an interesting reference point in the sense they are one of major category of loan default. References, to establish the residential identity of person from human contact point of view and cross check of their loans. In economic viability, we see installment to income ratio, fixed obligation to income ratio, loan to value, cost ratio. Now in bankability, we check bank statements, business continuity proof, credit interview, profile of customer, security, ownership title, civil report. Now in post-sanction details of retail loans, steps involved are delivering of offer letter, step 6, submission of legal documents and legal check, step 7, valuation report, step 8, registration of property documents, step 9, signing of agreements and submitting mandate for debiting account NACH, step 10, creation of security, registration with SARSAI, step 11, disbursement, step 12, monitoring. In monitoring, we do verification of end use of funds, monitoring for repayment, inspection, SARFAESI action when account becomes NPA. Priority sector for retail loans. Priority sector limits for various retail loans are: for housing loans in metro cities, rupees 35 lakhs, cost of the project rupees 45 lakhs comes under priority sector. At other places, rupees 25 lakhs of loan amount, where cost of the house is 30 lakhs, repair and renovation loan up to rupees 5 lakhs in metro and up to rupees 2 lakhs at other places comes under priority sector. It is important to note that staff loans does not comes under priority sector.
Loans to government agencies for houses, for slum clearance, rehabilitation, cost up to rupees 10 lakhs per house, housing projects for houses for EWS and LIG, cost rupees 10 lakhs per dwelling unit. Income defined by EWS and LIG in alignment with the income criteria specified under Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. Housing finance companies for all lending for houses, for slum clearance and rehabilitation, cost rupees 10 lakhs per borrower. Loans to housing finance companies is restricted to 5% of the individual bank's total priority sector lending on an ongoing basis. In education loans, loans to individuals including vocational courses up to rupees 10 lakhs irrespective of the sanctioned amount comes under priority sector. Now let's see education loan eligibility criteria defined by IIBF circular number RBL6 dated 6 August 2015, June 2016 is as under. Student eligibility. The student should be an Indian national, should have secured admission in the course, course eligible, studies in India, and indicative list. Approved courses leading to graduate, postgraduate, degree, and postgraduate diplomas conducted by recognized colleges, universities, recognized by UGC, government, AICTE, AIBMS, ICMR, etc. Courses like ICWA, CA, CFA, etc. Courses conducted by IIMs, IITs, IISc, XLRI, NIFT, NID, etc. Regular courses by Director General of Civil Aviation, Shipping, Degree, Diploma like Aeronautical, Pilot Training, Shipping, Degree Diploma in Nursing or any other discipline approved by Indian Nursing Council or any other regulatory body as the case may be if the course is pursued in India. Now, for studies abroad, courses eligible are graduation. For graduation, job-oriented professional technical courses offered by reputed universities. Post-graduation, MCA, MBA, MS, etc. Courses conducted by CIIMA London, CPA in USA, etc. Degree diploma courses like aeronautical, pilot training, shipping, etc. Provided these are recognized by competent regulatory bodies in India abroad for the purpose. Expenses considered. Fee payable to college, school, hostel, examination, library, laboratory fee, travel expenses, passage money for studies abroad, insurance premium for student borrower, caution deposit, building fund, refundable security deposit, supported by Indian institution bills, receipts. Purchase of books, equipment, instruments, uniforms. Purchase of computer at reasonable cost if required for completion of the course. Any other expense required to complete the course like study tours, project work, thesis. While computing loan required, scholarships, fee waiver, etc. if any may be taken into account. Quantum of finance. Studies in India up to 4 lakhs margin is nil. Above rupees 4 lakhs for studies in India margin is 5%. And for studies abroad, margin is 15%. However, up to rupees 7.5 lakhs, loan is eligible for credit guarantee coverage. Scholarship, assistantship to be included in margin. Margin may be brought on year-to-year basis as and when disbursements are made on a pro rata basis. Security, up to rupees 7.5 lakhs, parents to be joint borrowers, no security is required. Above rupees 7.5 lakhs, tangible collateral security, land properties or paper securities. Repayment period, repayment holiday moratorium is course period plus 1 year or 6 months after getting job, whichever is earlier. Repayment period, loan to be repaid in 15 years after the commencement of repayment. In case second loan is availed for higher studies later, to repay the combined loan amount in 15 years after completion of second course. Now let us see important points in education loan. Sanction of loan to more than one child from the same family is considered. Minimum age, no age restrictions, minor to ratify documentation after majority. Joint borrower, jointly with parents, guardian or spouse, parents-in-law after marriage. Students may submit their loan application either at bank branches near to the residence of parents or to educational institution. After the loan is sanctioned, the cases be transferred to the bank branch near to the institution for follow-up with student institution. The KYC compliance for the purpose has to be done by the branch nearest to the residence of parents. The loan to be disbursed stages after the requirement demand draft directly to the institutions, vendors of equipment, instruments to the extent possible. Now let us see what is Vidyalakshmi portal. Vidyalakshmi portal is a portal for seeking education loans. Portal has been developed under the guidance of Department of Financial Services, Ministry of Finance, Department of Higher Education, Ministry of Human Resource Development and IIBF. The portal has been developed and being maintained by NSDL e-governance. Students can view, apply and track education loan applications to banks anytime, anywhere by accessing the portal. The portal also provides linkages to National Scholarship Portal. Other important points. NCGTC. NCGTC is National Credit Guarantee Trustee Company set up on March 28, 2014 by Government of India under the Companies Act 1956. The fund shall provide guarantee cover up to the extent of 75% of the amount in default. The fund reserves the right to modify the same. The guarantee cover will commence from the date of payment of guarantee fee and shall run through the agreed tenure of the education loan. Guarantees by the fund. The guarantee is subject to the other provisions of the scheme NCGTC undertakes. In relation to education loans up to Rs. 7.5 lakhs extended to an eligible borrower by a member lending institution which has entered into the necessary agreement for the purpose with NCGTC to provide guarantee against default in repayment of education loans extended by the lending institutions. NCGTC reserves the right to accept or reject any proposal referred to it by the lending institutions which otherwise satisfies the norms of the scheme. Responsibilities of lending institutions under the scheme. The lending institution shall evaluate and sanction education loan in accordance with the IIBF model education loan scheme for pursuing higher studies in India and abroad and conduct the accounts of the borrower with normal banking prudence due diligence. The lending institution shall ensure linkage of every education with Aadhaar number and register the borrower's co-borrower's name with an appropriate credit information bureau. The lending institution shall closely monitor the borrower's account and follow up for repayment. Now let us see gold loans for any legitimate purpose, not for a speculative purpose. Loan limit, maximum up to Rs. 20 lakhs and minimum Rs. 20,000. Margin, gold loan margin 25%, liquid gold loan margin 25%, bullet repayment gold loans margin is 35%, processing fees is 0.5% of the loan amount plus applicable GST. However, the processing fees and interest rates can differ from bank to bank. Others, gold appraiser charges will be paid by the applicant. Repayment mode. Gold loan. The repayment of principal and interest will commence from the month following the month of disbursement. Liquid gold loan. Overdraft account with transaction facility and monthly interest is to be served. Bullet repayment gold loan. On or before the term of the loan, on closure of the account. Repayment period. In gold loan, maximum repayment period is 36 months. In liquid gold loan, it is 36 months. And in bullet repayment gold loan, it is 12 months. Eligibility. For availing gold loans, the age of the borrower should be 18 years and above. Profession. Any individual, singly or jointly, with steady source of income, including banks, employees, pensioners, no proof of income is required. Documents. Income proof of applicant and guarantors, if available. Residential proof of applicant and guarantors. PAN card of applicant and guarantors. KYC of applicant and guarantors. Security pledge of gold ornaments, duly verified for quality and quantity. Now let us see the difference between retail loans and commercial loans. Retail loan is based on pre-existing income. And commercial loan is based on projected income. Retail loan enhances ability of the borrower to spend more for consumption. Commercial loan enhances scale of production or volume of trade. The retail loan is provided if the income of the borrower over a period is sufficient to cover the loan repayment. Commercial loan. In commercial loan, the viability of the credit proposal is examined from a specific angle, whether the cash flow generated from the commercial assets like current assets, fixed assets is adequate to repay the loan. Working life of the borrower is important. In commercial loans, working life of asset created is important. In retail loans, we obtain the insurance of the borrower. In commercial loan, insurance of the asset is obtained. In retail loans, there is a standardized approach. In commercial loans, attribute-based analysis of financial statements, management, industry is performed. Now let us see some advantages and disadvantages of retail loans.
Now, advantages of retail loans are simple and structured product, easy to understand, easy to assess and process, diversification of risk, less NPAs, less impacted by economic downturn, stable net interest margin, no bargaining by customers, leads to widening of client base, cross-selling of products, lesser risk weight under Basel regime, stability in the loan portfolio, long-term customers acquisition, priority sector targets. Disadvantage: rate of interest is very low, can't link pricing to risk rating, can't increase interest rate, cutthroat competition among banks, leading to waiver of processing charges. Cost of handling customers is large, small ticket size leads to uneconomical allocation of manpower, vigorous follow-up needed, concentrating on small size borrowers will not contribute substantially to top and bottom line. Growth will not be visible quantitatively. Increasing incidence of fraud in retail loan accounts. So, all these are disadvantages of retail loans. So, friends, if you like the video, please like and subscribe our channel so that we continue to make helpful videos for you all. See you in next video.